What is going on, peeps? Welcome to episode 35 of Character Wars. And well, before we begin this singles battle featuring, well, the undefeated Shadow Man and undefeated Bardock, you might have noticed, like, some of the pictures have changed. And yes, Chuck Norris mentioned it earlier, a couple weeks ago, I believe, that roster cuts, roster realignments would be coming. So I believe there's 22 characters that were moved down to Matthew UKP's roster there, kind of sending them down to the D-League. A lot of these, they'll be completely cut from my roster there, so they'll be exclusive to his now. But you'll still see some characters kind of co-premiere, co-battle on his show, my show. Different divisions, though, usually. But, yeah, I digress. So, yeah, new character pictures showing up in there. That's just because, we finally got around to cutting some talent there. Most of those characters never debuted on the roster anyhow. But anyhow, on to this battle. Yes, an undefeated showdown to open this episode. Shadow Man at 3-0 will be going against Bardock at 2-0. Send him to the Nexus for this one as well. I don't think Bardock has officially used his Super Saiyan form yet. He hasn't even had to power up all the way. And, oh, Shadow Man wearing that red and black garb, so we know he's in serious business anytime he busts out his A-game colors. As well, Bardock and Shadow Man kind of holding each other at bay here. Looks like maybe Shadow Man has pulled slightly ahead there, but early on, no character with a clear advantage. Big smackdown there from Bardock as he powers up, dodges the shuriken, but that one connected. Takes to the shadows, however, Bardock finds him. Kick whiff there from Shadow Man. Punch combo dodged, and that one got through, but ooh, Bardock left himself open, and Shadow Man found that one. Looks like, well, Bardock, a little bit of trouble here, down to his last quarter of health, but he's doing well, kind of holding off Shadow Man's attacks until that happened. The big shuriken barrage, and well, Shadow Man, at least he stayed in the ring. He usually disappears after every round. Anyhow, round two underway. And well, he rushes in, gets smacked down. That is Shadow Man. Well, Bardock, big uppercut combo there. Kind of flying around, another neck toss there. As well, Shadow Man, found another weakness in Bardock's defense. Just going to work with the Shadow Clones. Massive combo. That did a big chunk of damage to Bardock. He's already under half health, but still fighting in this one here. Bardock actually getting back into this one. And we can see why he's undefeated here. Both these characters refusing to go down. And Shadow Man, I'd have to say, is the favorite here. But, Bardock able to power up. Is this going to do a massive amount of damage to Shadow Man? Yeah, he's down to a quarter. Bardock's pulled ahead in the round two here, or the second round, I should say. Another neck smash. Can Bardock force the third round? Big uppercut. One more hit, I would say. Ooh, energy blast. And, oh, I think he might be finished. Bardock, you had it, buddy. Oh, he's still in it. Kick connects. Bardock with the smash. He does force the third round. Wow, that was a competitive second round. I don't know who's going to take it. Shadow Man seems like he has this one whenever he wants it, but Bardock refuses to go down. Takes Shadow Man down to start round three here. Big punch combo. Uh-oh. The lineage of Saiyans. This is going to hurt. Is he going Super Saiyan? No, he just did a massive explosive punch, and Shadow Man in big trouble. Hasn't even hit Bardock in round three. Well, the Lineage of Goku just doing great here, finally. Ooh, Shadow Man taking the shadows, couple of shuriken barrages. Ooh, Bardock able to defend this time, actually kind of figuring out Shadow Man's offense. Ooh, not that Shadow Clone Assault, though. Shadow Man trying to take this one now, folks. I don't know who's going to take it. I think this is it. Bardock, big energy blast. Ooh, Shadow Man hangs on. Quarter health left. Less than a quarter. Ooh, big kick connects. Shadow Man literally is hanging on. And he is done, folks. I can't believe it. I would have to say that is an upset. Bardock remains undefeated. Moves up to 3-0. Takes out Shadow Man. And, wow, in a competitive, super awesome opening first battle here for episode 35. Singles actually not giving us a big beat down to open the show for once here. I am happy to see that none the least there. Anyhow, oh boy, we got another singles battle up next, and it looks like, if I'm checking the card right here, Thanos has finally weaseled his way up to the main show for a battle here. Who's he in action against? We'll find out up next. Episode 35 continues, and well, yes indeed, the Mad Titan Thanos himself in action this week on the main show. He comes in with a 4-1 record, his only loss coming to Rick out of all characters way back when on a Battleground episode. He's going to be squaring off against a character making a return to the roster. It's God Rugal. We haven't seen him in quite some time, officially coming in with a 0-0 record in this series. Like I say, his official re-debut, I guess we could say. And actually wearing his red gear instead of... I think he used to wear his like purple garb a lot in my series. Anyhow, Thanos strutting in here like he owns the place. I guess he's wearing his main gear. Oh my god, I didn't even really get a chance to see what he did. He beat God Rugal in 5 seconds. Well, that wasn't fun, Thanos. I guess he's proving once again. We've seen his promos that he shouldn't be taken lightly. I guess he deserves more time. But God Rugal hasn't even hit him. Come on. At least he lasted longer. There we go. God Rugal getting a few hits in this time. Tackling Thanos around here. And well, maybe the Mad Titan thought it was over and took God Rugal lightly. Ooh, it's still not over. Rugal hanging around. Well, he took half of Thanos' health and ran too, but...
It's not over.
No, I would say it is over, Thanos. You did stomp him there. Answer me with... I'm not even going to read that. We were not even going to dignify Thanos with the response after that. Well, God Rugal... I mean, if we would have got going in second round there, stayed going in the second round, he might have forced it, but Thanos just ended that. Moving up to 5-1 here. And, well, spoiling the return of God Rugal... I'm sure we'll see him bounce back, though, because it's been a long time, so he wasn't sure what he was getting himself into, I'm sure, this week. Anyhow, that concludes our singles bouts this week. It is time to transition to doubles. Let's find out who's in action up next. Episode 35 continues with our first double showdown of the show. This one features, well, Evil Ken and Evil Ryu making an appearance. They come in with a 2-1 record. They'll be battling, well, Mega Man and X. Mega Man X making an appearance here with a 1-1 record. Let's go ahead and send this to the Nexus folks as, well, I don't know. Mega Man and X, they can sometimes work pretty well as a team, but other times, I mean, if they just get overwhelmed. Evil Ken and Evil Ryu. What I'm saying is could be a beatdown battle. We'll find out. It's just the Mutul helmet always looks great on Mega Man. I guess not. Personally, I kind of like the other one. Anyhow. As X is already there. He's got like the red little jewel in his helmet there. He's the evolved version. Anyhow, let's see if he's evolved in combat to take out Evil Ken and Evil Ryu. As well, our Mega Man duo working over Evil Ken and Evil Ryu. Just endless spam of combos. Is this over? Wow. A flawless victory. I mean, Mega Man X...
Mission accomplished.
Exactly. I mean, that's the best way to say it there, Mega Man. Round two underway. Is this over as quick as this began? Well, at least this time, Evil Ken and Evil Ryu were able to make a little dent in Mega Man here. As X going full power. Mega Man himself, getting pushed back. A much more competitive round here. Evil Ken and Evil Ryu apparently let Mega Man X have the free round as, well, they are... putting the absolute clinic on now. A spam fest. And, well, Evil Ryu is just biding his time with the Hadouken of Doom there. And Evil Ken always trying to uppercut M. Bison. He never gets him. Anyhow, our final round underway. Will Mega Man X pull the upset after we saw what happened in round two? I think that's what we could expect in round three is... Well, X going full power! Evil Ken knocked out. It's a handicap match. I think Mega Man X might score a major upset here. Something we don't see. The evil duo wrecked. I mean, when Mega Man X, when they won, they just beat the crap out of Evil Ken and Evil Ryu. They literally obliterated those two there. I can't believe it. That is an upset. I saw X and Mega Man with a loss there. It's like, hey, Evil Ken, Evil Ryu, they have a loss too, but they're... a long-time established team, way back when, the old 2 vs 2 champions from the old Request series. probably one of the bigger upsets I've seen in 2 vs 2 showdown in a while, but definitely a competitive. Man, we saw another 3-round showdown to open up doubles this week here. Hopefully our next doubles battle will equal the intensity of this one. We will find out in just a minute. And episode 35 continues with the second doubles battle of the show. This one features, well, the most surprising undefeated 2 vs 2 team in the division, Bugs Bunny and Roadrunner, boasting a 3-0 record. They'll be taking on the twin snakes of Liquid Snake and Solid Snake, the Metal Gear duo. They were enemies, I guess they're brothers, and I guess they buried the hatchet. So I show them actually have a 1-0 record.
There's no way out for us.
Well, Speedy Gonzalez singing his Spanish song there to begin the match, and, well, Bugs taking a bite of the carrot, tossing the dynamite, rushes in, and, well, Roadrunner and Bugs Bunny, at least early on, I thought the snakes were in trouble as Liquid Snake takes out the assault rifle. Uh-oh, Roadrunner with the plan there. The boulder smash, Solid Snake took most of that here. A bunch of bombs being unlaid here. This one pretty competitive. Looks like the snakes kind of isolate one of the Looney Tunes. They might have the advantage, but this could be bad. Ooh, the big Jeep of Doom there from Liquid. That one is the big equalizer. Ooh, man, everybody falling off the cliff there. That's the Roadrunner's special. That might do in the snap. That was the end of Solid Snake. Not the way he expected to die in this round as well. Brother, I've left to fight by myself. Liquid Snake doing what he can, but... I mean, he gets the overhead smash, headbutt on Roadrunner, another headbutt on Roadrunner. Liquid holding his own. The turtle's coming out, but it's too little too late. Liquid unable to amount enough offense. Oh my god, Roadrunner being chased by Barney. You never know what's going to happen in these celebrations. Immediately, the cliff of death from the Roadrunner. He sacrifices Bugs in there too. He doesn't care. Everybody takes damage. This team is insane as well. Big, what was that, rocket launcher from Solid in there. Liquid Snake just absolutely owned as he tries to take the Jeep out. Roadrunner actually took the worst of that. Another cliff of death. Man, this is just action all over the place. Carnage abroad, folks. Hyper speed from Roadrunner. Liquid Snake felt that. And Solid Snake taking the grenade launcher, the Jeep again. Are we going to see a 3-rounder in this one? I don't know. The snakes need a miracle. Uh-oh. Liquid is dead. Solid in it by himself this time. Gets the big punch-kick combo. Uh-oh, but the plan is coming. The boulder launch of doom. Yes, you heard that. Smashing Solid Snake. And somehow, Roadrunner and Bugs Bunny are now 4-0. One of the top teams in twos there. No one anticipates the spamminess of that Roadrunner. I swear, he has to be the strong one on the team there. And Bugs Bunny gets those cheap turtle combos and stuff. And they kind of forget about him. And that's what we've seen. Every team they face is, I think, underestimate him. That's why the Bugs Bunny, the Looney Tunes duo of Bugs Bunny and Roadrunner have moved up to 4-0. Man. Well, Solid Snake and Liquid Snake back to the drawing board for our Twin Snake duo. But that will wrap up our doubles sets for this week, folks. It looks like it is time to transition to the 4 vs 4 main event showdown this week. We'll find out who's in action in that up next. Episode 35 has arrived with our 4 vs 4 main event of the show. The team on the left, it's Kirby, Krakow's Revenge, Mask DDD, and Meta Knight. It is the team known as the Nightmare in Dreamland. They are undefeated with a 2-0 record. They'll be squaring off, well, Jotaro and the JoJo's Stardust Crusade team here. They've added Kakuin to the team. They used to be an undefeated threes team at 2-0. Now adding Kakuin, this will be their first time since adding him moving to fours here. Let's find out if they're going to remain an undefeated team in the fours division, or if they're going to lose to a major powerhouse in the fours division. That is Nightmare in Dreamland. Well, this one is ready to go here. JoJo in the all black here. Oh, that evil cloud there. Krakow's Revenge. And Nasty EDD as well. I hear Kirby trying to eat. And it looks like the Stardust Crusaders in trouble. Oh man, massive cloud there. Krakow's Revenge is probably almost like a boss level character. I swear he is dangerous. But finally, our stand users. Wow, coming back. The Stardust Crusaders. Don't count them out. I can't tell who's left. I think we got Kirby in there. I think we got Mass DDD. I think I think everybody in Nightmare and Dreamland is still alive here. Meanwhile, our Stardust. Oh no, Krakow's Revenge is dead. Wow. I am having a hard time following this one. I think we got Abdol and Kakween left. Not anymore. We have Kirby, Meta Knight, and Mass DDD alive. Oh, he knocked his mask off. And Meta Knight. Yes, with the wooden quote there. Nightmare in Dreamland, living up to that. This match, a nightmare to follow. Commentate, impossible to follow all the action here. Looks like Abdol activating his stand, going to work here. Our stand user's trying, but Krakow's Revenge kind of going to, he's using his ranged abilities here. And that will be absolutely bad for our Stardust Crusaders. Pulling around after actually trying to get in there. Krakow's Revenge is kind of bouncing around. I'm kind of focusing on him. The big storm cloud of death is kind of the easiest character to watch, I guess. Because he doesn't kind of move a lot. Anyhow. Man, Kirby's still trying to eat somebody. Nasty EDD with the massive hammer spin in there. I think, who is dead? It's, Jotaro, Polnareff. Is it just Abdol left standing here? It looks like it. And Muhammad Abdol has his work cut out for him. I think this is over. Stand using, tried to use his stand there, but Nasty EDD's hammer launching rockets there. All four members of the Nightmare in Dreamland survived this one. As well, Kirby falls asleep there. I mean, quick enough to sleep after that. Kirby must have exerted a lot of energy, needed a nap. I don't know what happened there. Our Stardust Crusaders team, though. Well, they were good in threes, adding Kakuin to the roster, the team may have been their downfall. But then again, like I say, they face potentially the strongest fours team on the roster right now. We don't know. I mean, a lot of these undefeated fours teams haven't had a chance to square off, but they will with the addition, like, Battleground having the threes and fours and rebound as well. But I digress there, folks. Nightmare in Dreamland moves on to 3-0. And the Stardust Crusade Fours Brigade lose their debut battle in the Fours Division here this week. But anyhow, yeah, I still will have Battleground and Rebound coming up for you guys on a Sunday. And I believe we'll probably have some more from Mr. UKP this week as well with his MUGEN is War and Heat series there, so hopefully we will get some more of that. I plan on streaming probably some Final Fantasy VII Remake over on the Twitch if anyone's interested in that today. But again, I appreciate y'all watching episode 35 here, and I hope y'all have a great rest of your weekend.